We have one more tab here in the Appearance Preferences, the Theme tab. Clicking that, I see one called Custom. Then we've got Mint X, Mint X Aqua, Mint X Blue, and it looks like we've got about 10 plus the Custom, ending with Mint X Sand and Mint X Teal. To see how these work a little better, I'm going to open up a couple windows, the Update Manager and the File Manager. I am going to select Mint X Sand, and we see in the Update Manager, if I check these, the selection identifier is now brown and the checkboxes are brown. Over in the File Manager, we see the files are now that sandy brown, as well as the selection identifier here and all the icons. Up on the desktop, we've got the home folder, the brown color, and when I select on the computer, the icon selected is also that sandy brown color. I'm going back over to the Appearance Preferences. I'm going to click on the Customize button. We see that we're in the Controls tab and we've got Mint X Sand. I'm going to click on Mint X Red. We notice right away that we're no longer in Mint X Sand. We're now in Custom. And it is highlighted in the red color, got the red buttons. Down in the Update Manager, our checkboxes are red. In the File Manager, the selection criteria is red, as well as on the desktop. Whatever is selected is now red instead of brown. If I come all the way down to Thin Ice and select that, we'll notice that some backgrounds change as well. We'll see more about that when we look at these other tabs. I'm going back to the Mint X Red for the controls, and I will go over to Pointer. We've got a choice of the black pointer or the white pointer. I'll choose the black one. And now I'll go over to Icons, which looks like it's basically that folder color. I will select Mint X Teal. We see these all change to the teal color. We still have the red for our selection criteria. And then I'm going to close this and Save As. I'm going to give it the name TFCG1 and save it. We see it in our themes. If I switch over to Mint X Purple, we see everything is purple. Going back and selecting our new theme brings back the theme we just created. Going back into Customize, we still have the Windows border. We're on the Mint X. I'm going to click on the very next one down called Simple. We see right away that our title bar changes. It now has a border and a background. We see that the context button turns into the icon for that window. What I mean by that, this is the context window, and the icon for the Appearance Preferences is the tie and coat. Over in the File Manager, the icon is a folder, and in our Update Manager, the icon for that is the shield. And we talked about the title bar. Then we've got the minimize, maximize, and close buttons. We'll also notice that the corners of our windows are now square, whereas they were more round when we had the Mint X theme. Looking at more of these themes, we see they're all pretty similar, and they're pretty much self-descriptive. Coming down a little further, we see one called EOS. When I click that, we see the round buttons like a Mac. We'll also notice that we don't have a way to change the buttons to the left side like a Mac. There is a way to do that, just not in this window. We'll see how to do that in the next video. We're not doing that now because it's not in the Appearance Preference window. For now, I'm going to select this one at the bottom, WinME. We'll notice that the active window has got the white text and blue background theme for the title bar, and all the others have got the gray background and text for the title bar. This last window is for colors. And I'm going to start down at the bottom with the tooltips, yellow and black. If I hover over one of these buttons, even the minimize and maximize, we see the tooltip telling us that minimize window, maximize window. I want to change these. I will make this red. With blue text. Now when I hover over a button, we see the red background with the blue text. The next one we're going to look at is the selected items. I'm going to make a purple background with some green text. And in our file manager window, we see the purple background with green text. On the desktop, we see the purple background with the green text. But down in our update manager, we see the green text, but the selection criteria is red. Same with the left side here. We've got the red background. That's because it's getting that from the controls. If I come back over to controls, and scroll up to the top, I can set this to clear looks. Now we see the purple background for our selection. These last two, input boxes and windows. I'm going to change the input to aqua with yellow text. And the windows to be blue with white text. That bright blue is showing us where our window is, as well as the white text for that. But we also see in the title bar, the selected window has got the white text, and the unselected windows have got the blue text. Let's change this from blue to black. And now we see that we still have the white text for the selected window, but the text on all the unselected windows is black. I'm going to close this and save it as that same file name. It's asking me if I want to overwrite it. I do. And when I come down and select something like teal and go back to our new TFCG1, we notice it went to the one we saved the first time. To get this to work properly, I'm going to have to close this window and reopen it. And there it is. I'm going back to the original Mintex. And down here it says get more themes online. If you want to add more themes, it's much better to come down to Menu, Software Manager, and type in themes in the search bar. And here we see three themes. I'm going to click on the Mate themes and install them. I'll close this window and refresh our themes by closing it and reopening. They've got a couple here like Green Laguna. and black mate that are pretty popular. I think I'll go with the Green Laguna. And if I want to go back to the original, I just find Mintex.